You're tuning into Black and White Sports on YouTube. The no-holds-barred truth on sports. The main event starts now.
Man, did we talk about Shohei Ohtani last week and all that money? Yeah, Shohei Ohtani got $700 million.
Yeah, he's deferred a little bit for tax reasons, didn't he?
Yeah, he's only going to get paid like the Dodgers only going to pay him like $2 million a year, but the $68 million a year is going to be deferred like so pretty much after the deal.
Yeah, like the Bobby
it's almost
Bonilla
like a Bobby Bonilla kind of thing.
Yeah,
but the word is coming out now. There is a reason why Shohei Ohtani did not want to go to San Francisco.
Yeah, because it was a crime-ridden shithole. But Buster Posey done something about that.
Yeah, it's right here. Former Giant Buster Posey says crime drugs affected Shohei Ohtani's decision not to come to San Francisco. I'm not surprised by this.
No,
I mean,
not.
He went to L.A. L.A. still has bad crime, but I think that San Francisco is way worse than L.A.
Oh, San Fran. It's not called San Fran shithole for anything, is it?
No.
That's what Jericho.
I mean, because in San Francisco, man, in San Francisco, you can actually steal under $900, and they're not even really going to arrest you. I did a video months ago this summer, and CNN was actually in a Walgreens in San Francisco. They witnessed three thefts in 30 minutes. And there's a reason why all these stores like closing. They want to get out of these cities. But look here. It says former Giants megastar Buster Posey has claimed that current baseball star Shohei Ohtani declined a contract with the team and chose the Los Angeles Dodgers due to San Francisco's poor reputation as a city.
Yeah.
Quote. Ohtani's stats as a slugger and a pitcher basically match up to Babe Ruth's at this point in his career, noted the NBC Bay Area. Quote, he's an impossibly rare talent with that combo, and the SWAT of Dodgers have signed him to a 10-year, $700 million deal.
Yeah.
Though the San Francisco Giants offered Ohtani a contract nearly identical to the Dodgers, experts believe the city's reputation, which has quickly become a fecal-infested homeless den of crime in recent years, would hinder the deal.
Yeah, because they're allowing the homeless to take a dump on the streets there and all that.
Yeah, it's disgusting. It's a complete hellhole out there. Quote. When it comes to Shohei Ohtani, they recognize that he had a comfort level in Southern California, and that was going to be a difficult thing, said Andrew Baggerly of The Athletic. Buster Posey agreed, quote, there's been a bit of uneasiness with the city itself as far as the state of the city with crime and drugs, Posey said to Baggerly. There was some reservation. Posey said that other free agents have expressed a similar concern. San Francisco supervisor Matt Dorsey, who represents the district where the Giants play, said that he has heard similar complaints from businesses within the city. Quote, what I heard from Buster Posey is what I've heard from large employers and what I've heard from businesses that San Francisco needs to do a better job at progress on its public safety challenges, said Dorsey. Dorsey has been campaigning on full police staffing. Well, good luck with that. I mean, remember San Francisco defunded their police.
Yeah, you look at the Bay Area itself, Oakland, Sacramento, they're all gang-ridden shitholes as well.
Yeah. I think the Warriors actually play in San Francisco now.
They're playing San Fran now, yeah.
No, they left Oakland and then they went to across the Bay to San Francisco.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't blame Shohei. I mean, if crime, crime's really, really bad. Still, I guess he wanted the money, but he took the lesser of two evils, considering, you know, the money was similar. Because how many other teams would actually pay him that kind of money?
So with Japanese culture like that as well and all that, like that, they deem cleanliness as a big thing there as well. So you can't blame him for turning down San Francisco and all that. Like when you get vagrants taking shit on the streets and all that, and full view of tourists and all that.
Yeah. I mean, that's disgusting. I've never been to San Francisco. I have no desire to go there. That city is still one of the most expensive cities to live in the world, even with all the crime. And I'm pretty sure he's losing a whole bunch of money to taxes, too.
Would you say it'd be more expensive in New York?
What's that?
Would you say it'd be more expensive in New York, San Francisco?
I think New York is more expensive than San Fran.
Yeah.
But they're both cities have bad crime, but San Francisco is by far the worst out of the two.
So I kind of got lucky
really
in New York.
Bad
when I was in New York last year and all that, like I didn't see the only thing I've got when me and my wife went to Yankee Stadium, because we were supposed to go to a game there, and we was in the Bronx and all that, like we got out of the Family Dollar and all that, like, and we was advised to get the fuck out of there.
Yeah.
But other than that, we had no issues with New York at all. But like I say, as for vagrants and all that, I saw a couple of homeless, and that was in a diner. But I didn't see anyone sleeping. Mind you, I did see a couple of maniacs who were shouting and screaming and all that. I don't know if they're homeless or not, or just complete lunatics. But I saw more vagrants out in Boston than I did in New York. And half of them were vets, ex-military as well.
Oh, okay. I've been through New York one time, when I was in the military, but I never really had any desire to go to New York City. I wouldn't live there either. I mean,
I wouldn't. No, I wouldn't live in New York. No, I'd go back to New York because I would like
to go for the pizza. I would like to try the pizza.
Oh, that pizza's good. Yeah, pizza's
I heard
so
the pizza's
good.
Really, really good.
Yeah, Joe's Pizzeria are the places to go.
I heard Lombardi's is really good.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching the show. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to tune in next time on Black and White Sports.